This is not a dosa that's roasted kadak. There is a crispness, there is a crunch, but it's a whisper of a crunch. I'm going to get a bite of that idli with that chutney and also with that curry leaf. Just for that added flavor, zing. Hi folks, I'm in Jayanagar in South Bengaluru and I've come here to visit an establishment that's perhaps the most popular currently for its tiffin or South Indian snacks. We're at Taaza Thindi, an establishment that in a very short span of 6 years only has become the go-to establishment for South Indian snacks. So let's go in and find out what a Taaza Thindi experience is all about. Let's go. I came here only about 15-20 minutes ago, just before the place was about to open. They open at 4:30 p.m. It's not even 5. There was already a queue of people out here, and in 15-20 minutes, this place is packed. That's testament to the popularity of this establishment. Well, that's the menu that they have here. There are all of 5 items on the menu, from the idli, the vada, the Kesari Baath, Khara Baath, Chowchow Baath, and the dosa. So when we did our dosa trail in Bengaluru, we did cover Taaza Thindi as part of Bengaluru's top dosas too, where I tasted the Masala Dose. So do look out for that video. I'm going to place a link to that video somewhere up here and also in the description below. But today we are here to taste all the dishes that are on the menu here at Taaza Thindi. So before we taste all those dishes, let's go in and find out what makes Taaza Thindi tick. Let's go. So that's Mr. Srinivas Rao, who's the founder, the pioneer, the creative force behind Taaza Thindi. And here's Mr. Chengappa, who is the managing partner for Taaza Thindi, who looks after all the operations. Yes. I can hear the dosas being fired on the pans there. It's an incessant stream of dosas. I can hear that constant sizzle of that dosa pan. There are people milling around, waiting for their orders. I can see steam going out as people are being served their idlis, the vadas. That's how popular this place is. So, how do you maintain your busy ishtu ide?
Namma planning aatara ide.
Andre mukhya illi nimdu kitchen.
Yes.
So, nimdu kitchen nodabodha? So, let's go in and check out the kitchen here at Taaza Thindi. The nerve center of the operation here. Let's go. So, there's a parcel counter here. So, if you want to parcel, if you want to take away food, it says bring your own container. It's as eco-friendly as that. Clean to the dishwasher. You know, if you look at the setup that they have here, it perhaps rivals some of the best that I've seen in 5-star establishments. So basically, they don't just wash it, they also sterilize the plates, the spoons. That's what this is. So this is a dishwasher and a sterilizing unit. And not to forget, they use organic dishwash. So if you're worried about hygiene, cleanliness, well, at this place, you absolutely don't need to worry about it. So it's hot, they wipe it and then they send it to the counter. So there's a grinding section. There's an army of grinding machines here.
Hi.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Pleasure meeting you.
So you are also one of the founders of...
Yeah, I'm one of the founders, founding director of Taaza Thindi.
Okay.
This is a vision of our MD, Mr. Gopadi Srinivas Rao. He started with a vision of clean food, affordable food, and to reach all the segments of the customers.
Wow, so it's clean food, affordable food, and to reach all segments.
Okay.
So anybody should be able to come into Taaza Thindi and enjoy a meal.
Yes. That is the main motto of Taaza Thindi.
Wonderful.
And if you see Taaza Thindi, we don't have doors anywhere.
Okay.
The concept is live. The customer can walk in here, he can see the process, the customer can go inside the store, he can check the raw materials, he can go inside the kitchen, check the process of production and all the things. Generally what happens is very unorganized segment, and we give a lot of training to the employees. We say that you have to keep this clean. But sometimes what happens in the work pressure, generally they tend to forget a lot of things, and there are instances where the hygiene is compromised in other places. But here, because we don't have a door and customers are
just walking
all the time, they are coming in, they are on their toes and they are forced to keep it also.
Well, that's a very interesting concept. So you basically, in a manner of speaking, have got the customers working for you. So your customers are your quality inspectors.
Yes.
Right?
Of course. You're right.
That's interesting. So if you look at all the dosas, they all to the correct size. All of them are uniform. So there's that red chutney lashing that has gone on the masala dosa. So plain ali bara lado. The consistency of the potato is almost like a mousse. He's actually pouring it on top of each dosa. So every 4 to 7 minutes, they dish out about 15 dosas. And he says, we don't have count of how many dosas we dish out, probably in the thousands. Weekends ke jaasti. Well, not only are the glasses sterilized, but they also come here and they're placed in a hot case. So the glasses are heated even as they are kept ready here. So the heat will obviously kill anything that's unwanted there. Hot vada is being prepared here. Vada is crunchy, but it's crunchy.
Heat to mixing.
Heat to mixing.
It's a different
difference. Different. So, adrali adu crunchy. Thank you, sir. Kai illa trace maadidare.
Busy irutte.
Oh, busy ide. Busy ide. Oh, this vada is
crispy.
Is crispy, breaking almost like a biscuit. You can see that wisp of steam escape from that vada the moment I break into it. This vada is as fresh as that. You can see that steam escape from that vada. This vada is crunchy on the outside, almost like a biscuit, but it's soft, airy and porous inside. Just the way a good vada should be. That crunch of the vada. Taste some of that vada with the chutney. That chutney is generous in the coconut. So having gotten a teaser of the dishes that await for us here at Taaza Thindi, I can't wait to get to the front of the restaurant and taste the 4 or 5 dishes that they have on offer. Let's go. During our kitchen tour, I think the crowd has only increased and there's a line already of people at the counter waiting to order their dishes. So ordering here is a simple affair. Although it's hugely crowded, it can seem chaotic, but it's not. So stand in the line, look at the 4 or 5 dishes that they have. By the time you reach the cash counter, you figured out pretty much the dishes that you want to order. Probably the idli or the vada or the Kesari Baath, but here we're going to order all of them. On the idli, idli vada. On the plate, idli vada. Mate on the Kesari Baath, Khara Baath. Well, I've got all the dishes here. I've got the Chowchow Baath, I've got the Idli Vada, I've got plain dosa sa patrala, plain dosa, masala dosa, and the coffee, and all of it for the princely sum of 115 rupees only. Suru Idli Vada kodi nange. Oh, I got a double Idli and a single Vada. Even the spoon is under a warmer of sorts, so they really take their hygiene very seriously. It's quite hot. You know it. This is a sort of place that looks crowded from the outside, but once you come in, you tend to find your spot, you tend to find your corner, and then get ready to tuck into some good food.
Very tasty, hygienic.
Tasty, hygienic. Eshtu varshinda bartidira neevu?
Sports open agidalla
ba. 6 varshinda.
Everything is fine and hygienic.
Fine and hygienic, correct.
Because of that, we come here.
Neevu olegesa nodidira kitchen ella?
It is open to public.
That's right, it's open to public. So you know, that's the one thing about this space here. So we just did our kitchen tour and we came back out. And the one USP out here is there is no door that divides the restaurant from the kitchen. So as a customer, you're free to walk in, explore, see what's happening. Assure yourself that the food's being prepared in a hygienic manner before you walk up to the counter and order whatever your heart desires. And I think that's extremely unique in this business. So all said and done, like they say, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. In this case, the idli and the vada. I can't wait to get started. There's nothing like holding your food, because I think when you touch the food and you feel its warmth, you feel its texture, it connects you to the food even before you place it in your mouth. I want to taste this idli just by itself first. I love the grainy texture of that idli. Well, the chutney here is a liquidy, almost watery sort of a chutney at first glance. But you can see the mustard seeds in there. You can see some flecks of chili, perhaps some dill. You know, what's interesting here are the chutneys. The chutneys are what lend flavor to the dishes. So what you have to do is drench your idli with all that chutney You know, first I thought the idli, the chutney was a little watery, but then you realize that the consistency is just perfect to bathe your idli with all that chutney. I think I need some more chutney here. Oh, you can see all the goodness of this. There's some chili in there, there's some curry leaf as well, there's some mustard seeds that serves to make for a spicy chutney. Oh, the gatti chutney is also there. Sulpa gatti chutney is the cold vada. You know, when you drench that idli in that chutney and place it in your mouth, that idli disappears almost magically. It melts away in your mouth. That's how soft and airy and porous that idli is. I think it's time to taste that vade now. I've tasted some of the vade just hot off the stove inside. Taste some more with some chutney. That crunch of the vade. If a vade is well made, you got to bite into that crunch from the beginning to the end. That's the hallmark of a good vade. And that's what this vade is all about. Simple, clean flavors, the right texture, a crisp, almost biscuity exterior and a soft, porous, airy inside. That's the hallmark of a good vade. You can hear the crunch of the vade despite all the noise around here. I'm going to taste that vade now with the chutney. Nape that vade with all that chutney. Oh, that's a seriously good vade. What's also nice is the size of the vade. It's just the right size which makes for a great snack. And I think the idea is when you come to Taaza Thindi, you want to taste more than one thing. So you want to taste the vade, you want to taste a couple of idlis. Perhaps if you feel a little more indulgent, taste one of the doses. So the portions are just that. And I think what's also interesting is the fact that the prices are extremely, extremely reasonable. Actually, I wouldn't use the word reasonable, I would use the word cheap. Where can you get an idli or a vade in this day and age for 10 rupees? Where can you get a masala dosa for 25 rupees? So there's been inflation over the last 3 or 5 years, but the prices here at Taaza Thindi haven't changed at all. And neither has the quality, as we've just heard from some of the customers. I'm going to now smear some of that gatti chutney. So I'm told the gatti chutney is typically served with a dosa, but we've requested for some gatti chutney with the idli as well. I love the soft, porous, graininess of that idli. Clean in its flavors with none of the tartness that sometimes could appear if the idli, if the batter has over-fermented a wee bit. Well, I finished my chutney and I still have half a idli left. So I'm a little embarrassed to go back and ask for some more chutney, but I think I will. So we got some more chutney this time and also got some of that curry leaf. I'm going to get a bite of that idli with that chutney and also with that curry leaf. Just for that added flavor, zing. You know, there's a reason why we love our curry leaf so much in the south. Its ability to uplift, to add serious flavor is unbeatable. As in the case of this idli. Well, this idli vade here has been the perfect start to our thindi experience here at Taaza Thindi. Let's go and check out some of the other dishes. This is the old Bangalore feeling. You find a katte somewhere which is skirting a tree and you make yourself comfortable under it. Like I have with this Chowchow Baath combination. Kesari Baath and the Khara Baath.
Now the Khara Baath here is made with the bansi wheat rava.
And that's the reason why the consistency is a bit like a porridge. And I've been told that they do this seasonal. So for example, this time around, the Khara Baath has some avre kalu, some hyacinth beans in it. And that changes. So sometimes it's vegetable, but today it's the hyacinth bean or the avre kalu. And the Kesari Baath also changes depending on what's available. But let's begin with that Khara Baath. You know, there's a fair bit of tomato in this Khara Baath, which is made of rice rava. So you definitely taste the savouriness of the masala, but also the tartness that comes from the tomato that you can see generously used in that Khara Baath masala. And then you taste the soft bite of that avre kalu, that hyacinth bean. To be honest, this is probably one of my favorite Khara Baaths that I've tasted in a long time. The texture is quite unusual, very different as opposed to, let's say, a Khara Baath that's more solid, perhaps a little more clumpy. This is almost porridge-like in its consistency. When you taste it,
you taste that grainy creaminess of that bansi rava.
the spicing of that masala and then the tartness of that tomato and then that gentle bite of the avrek aloo. This certainly makes for a flavorful bite. And I like the fact that they're very generous with the avrek aloo in this. So every bite of the Khara Baath, I've tasted one avrek aloo. I can now also begin to taste some sweetness that comes from the Kesari Baath. Perhaps signaling that it's time now to move from the spicy to the sweet, from the Khara Baath to the Kesari Baath. Well, you can see there's some cloves here. There's some cashew as well. Some raisin in there. You can also see some of that ghee that's beginning to leave that Kesari Baath. So you know this is going to be a rich ghee laden bite. Kesari Baath is mellow, is gentle. You can taste the ghee. That's the first thing that you taste on your palate. There's a certain weight to the sweetness of this Kesari Baath.
And I think that perhaps comes from the fact that there is some kharbuja, muskmelon that has gone into it.
And that perhaps also explains in that slightly off-white color of this Kesari Baath. The flavor of the clove wafts through your mouth as you taste that Kesari Baath. I'm going to go for a full-on mouthful now with the Kesari Baath, with some of that raisin, with that cashew and the cloves. Yeah, the soft crunch of the toasted cashew, the sweet pop of the raisin of the kishmish and the flavorful spicy attack of the clove. I love that Kesari Baath. That cashew is roasted to that perfect toasty brown. So add some of that Khara Baath, introduce that Khara Baath to the Kesari Baath and make for a mouthful of the spicy Khara Baath and that sweet Kesari Baath. Next, we need to taste the dosa. Here at Taaza Thindi. All around you can see people just tucking into the tiffin here. Whether it's on the katte out there, whether it's on the benches here, the counter here, or sitting along the wall here. Everybody is tucking into their thindi here. Let's start plain kodi, amele masale. Plain thindi mele masale ke bartan puna. So I got my plain dosa here. So the plain dosa has no kempu chutney. It's just a dosa in itself with some ghee that's smeared on top and some chutney. Let's find a spot where we can sit and enjoy this dosa. Oh, that's a crisp dosa. As you break into the dosa, there's a whisper of a crunch. So you know it's going to be crisp on the outside and soft inside, but it's not cut up. What I like here is that the portions are quite manageable. So for example, when you taste one of these dosas, I don't think it's going to fill you up. It's going to leave you a bit hungry. So probably order one of the idli, perhaps the vada, or perhaps that Khara Baath, Kesari Baath combination. There's a bit of tartness that you taste from the fermentation of the batter. What's really special about this dosa is that whisper of a crunch. It's not overly cut up and there's a fair bit of the ghee and perhaps some oil that you can definitely feel on your fingers. I'm going to taste this dosa now with that gatti chutney. You can definitely taste the toastiness of the curry leaves in that chutney. That dosa seeks the flavorful company of that chutney. There's a bit of chili in this bite, also some curry leaves. I think this is the fourth thing that I'm tasting here at Taaza Thindi. And I've tasted each one of the dishes down to that last bite. But there's none of that heaviness that you can sometimes taste when you're eating food like this. I still feel light and I definitely feel like I can manage that masala dosa and some more. So it's quite evident that there's a lot of care that goes into the ingredients that go into the food here at Taaza Thindi. Lovely. So there's even a system in the manner in which the plates are placed on the counter. It's placed on this mat so the plates don't get damaged. So I think the first thing, it's got the perfect colouring, which is what you really appreciate in a well-roasted dosa. So it's got that golden brown crust. This flecks of red that I can see, and I think that's perhaps the kempu chutney that is making itself visible on the outside from the inside. It's just got the touch of that kempu chutney and that masala here. It's beginning to get crowded again. So when we came in, this place was crowded, was packed. And then there was a bit of an ebb. But suddenly now, I think it's it's past 6:30, it's beginning to get crowded again. Oh, this is glistening away with that ghee that was ladled on top of this dosa just as it was served. Just go for a teeny weeny bite first. You can see that palya, you can see some of that onion there, and that tempu chutney. I love the gentle whisper of a crunch that this dosa conveys to your palate. This is not a dosa that's roasted kadak. There is a crispness, there is a crunch, but it's a whisper of a crunch. You can definitely taste the flavor of that onion in that palya. Get some more of that palya there. I love that crunch of the dosa. That gentle crunch all the way to the end. And you can also taste the pointed spiciness of that chutney, of that gembu chutney. To some, this dosa may look like it's dripping in ghee and oil. This is my fifth plate here at Taaza Thindi that I'm finishing down to the very end. But I'm not feeling heavy at all. None of that. And I'm quite surprised myself. I got a pea here. Get some of that peas. The alugate palya is almost the consistency of a mousse. Of a soft, flavorful, savory mousse. Definitely taste the butteriness of that ghee there. I think it's time to introduce a dosa to that chutney, to that gatti chutney. Just cradle a generous serving of the chutney on the dosa. Yeah, the crunch of the dosa and that spicy aggression of that chutney. That chutney is generous in the amount of coconut. You got the kai, the coconut, you've got the green chilies, you've got some coriander, you've got a copious amount of mustard seeds as well. This is a 25 rupee dosa, but it certainly doesn't taste like one. This probably tastes like a dosa that you would happily eat even if you paid close to twice the amount. I've got the palya, the dosa and the chutney in this bite. With that strand of onion hanging on, also wanting to join the party of flavors in this bite. We've done the idli, we've done the vada, we've done the Chowchow Baath, which is the Kesari Baath, Khara Baath, we've done the plain dosa, the masala dosa. Time now to do the coffee. Everything is calibrated, so it's 70 ml of coffee or tea that you get. There's no buy two service, and if you want an extra empty glass, you pay rupees 3. I forgot to tell him that I want sugar to be less, but he says that the sugar is light anyways. Let's taste this. That's perfect. So you got that bitterness of that coffee and just that sweetness of the sugar somewhere lingering in the background. I thought I'd enjoy my coffee in some relative peace and quiet after emerging from the hustle and bustle of Taaza Thindi inside. Well, I've spent the last couple of hours here at Taaza Thindi exploring the space in detail. I went into the kitchen, went into each and every area of the kitchen. That very unique kitchen that they have here, which has no doors that separate it from the restaurant. Well, I've enjoyed my experience here, including the 5 dishes that's on the Taaza Thindi menu. I've savored those dishes down to that last morsel, and that's speaking something. And the surprising fact is that I don't feel heavy in the least. And I think that's testament to the quality of ingredients that go into the dishes here at Taaza Thindi. It's a sort of food that leaves you happy and light at the end of the day. I think in this day and age of rampant commercialism, Taaza Thindi comes across as a breath of fresh air. Here's an establishment that seeks to serve in the most hygienic conditions possible, that seeks to use the best material possible, and at prices that really won't burn a hole in your pocket. And I'm told that these prices have held steady for the last 5 years. And I think that's testament to the philosophy of this restaurant. Well, if you're in Bengaluru and you haven't savored a Taaza Thindi experience yet, make sure you get here and savor and taste all the 5 dishes that they have on offer. For Taaza Thindi truly is a unique and special eatery that has captured the hearts of people living in this part of Bengaluru. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating or drinking. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, Do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!